Assalamu alaikum students, your instructor Abdul Rafi here. So this is lecture number 3 and concept number 3 on the sampling and estimation of S2 Statistics 2 9709 A-level Mathematics. So we have already discussed about sample size and the sample mean central limit theorem. Now the discussion will be on not much difficult but very important concept, and a very important like 4 to 5 marks question can easily come. That is, we are going to discuss, sir, the unbiased estimate of the population mean and variance. That is concept number 3. And now we are in the topic of estimation as well, because this chapter is about sampling and estimation. So now we are discussing estimation as well. So what is basically, sir, unbiased estimate of population mean and variance? As I said, that concepts are very important. Although there are formulas in this concept, we have to do formulas, and we'll apply the formulas in practical past paper questions as we are doing. First, let's understand the theory, and then let's work it out with the past paper questions as well. So if we need to understand what is unbiased estimates of population mean and variance, we must know that when we have binomial distribution, okay, so when we have, sir, binomial distribution, we know that in the, sir, binomial distribution, we have n, that is number of observations, and the p, that is probability of success. Okay, so these are the, we need to know about n and p in binomial distribution, sir. We need to know about n and p, where n is the number of observations and p is the probability of success as well. Similarly, when we talk about, sir, the Poisson distribution, sir, so if you talk about the Poisson distribution, students, Poisson distribution, we talked about the lambda, that is the mean in terms of the lambda value. That is basically Poisson distribution. We need to know about this lambda, this thing, okay? Similarly, sir, if we talk about normal distribution, very common and crystal clear, in normal distribution, we need to know, sir, about the mean and the variance, right? So, sir, this is basically the mean and this is basically the variance, okay? So we already know mean and variance in the normal distribution as well. So, sir, why are you telling this? Because these things are called, this is what I've written here, are basically called the population parameters of these distributions, okay? So these are called, sir, population parameters, okay? Everyone getting it? So, sir, this is basically called population parameters of, heading for this. When we have n and p for binomial distribution and mean and variance for normal distribution, so when we know that these are the population parameters for these respective distributions simultaneously, we need to understand that, let's say, if the question is not giving a distribution to us, okay? So what we are saying is basically we are imagining, or we'll look into the question as well, that the question is not giving us the population parameter. So if you do not know the particular population parameter, students, if we do not know this, okay? So let's write it down. If you do not know this, what we can do is basically, we can basically make an estimate of the population parameter of the random sample. You could take a random sample from the distribution and make an estimate, okay? So we are taking random sample of distribution and making an estimate, random sample. So we are making a random sample and taking an estimate, which is called unbiased as well, which is also called unbiased as well for the population parameter. Okay, this estimate is unbiased because if the mean of the larger number of values taken in the same way can be equal to the true value of the parameter. Why it is unbiased, sir? Because the mean of a large number, let's say the mean of the large number of values can be equal, mean of large number of values can be equal to the true value of the parameter. And that is why we call this an unbiased estimate. True value of the parameter. So that is the reason we are saying that these are unbiased estimates, because you will look in the exam question, students, I'll show you on couple of questions now, in which you don't know whether it's binomial, Poisson or normal. So we have to make an estimate, and that estimate is unbiased, okay? Coming to the main important point, sir. So in this case, we have basically this thing is denoted, This is basically the unbiased estimate of the population mean, also called for X bar, okay? So unbiased estimate of the population mean, you will have to find summation of X divided by N. Very simple formula, just like representation of data for S1, okay? So this is basically unbiased estimate of the population mean, okay? Unbiased estimate of population mean formula. Unbiased estimate of population mean formula, and variance is denoted by S square. You need to make sure, students, you know the language of statistics. Language of statistics is very important. So S square is basically 1 divided by N minus 1, okay? So S square is basically the variance, N 1 divided by N minus 1, multiply by, this is, these are the formulas, summation of X square, okay? So summation of X square minus summation of X to the power of whole square, divided by sample size, whatever the value is coming for this, you have to multiply with 1 over N minus 1. This is basically the population variance, okay? This will be called population variance, okay, students? So population variance is called this thing, okay? Population variance. So these are the formulas in the red color, students, where mean is denoted by cap, the hat, or if we call this hat as well or cap as well. For population mean, both of them are unbiased estimate, students, and S square is basically the variance, where 1 divided by N minus 1, we multiply summation of X square minus summation of X whole square divided by N. So let me just put them in a frame as well, so everyone can understand this, revise it later and from the notes as well, okay? So here we go. This one is done. Basically, these are the formulas. And now, once you have understood this, let's try to apply on the practice questions as well of this topic, okay? So unbiased estimate, concept number 3. Hope everyone have copied the formulas and note them down. So let's work it out quickly. Page number 26. Again, I'll write it down first that this is, sir, concept number 3. And we are basically learning concept number 3, that is unbiased estimates of the population mean and variance, students. We have this question from the recent paper, that is, sir, May, June 2018, question number 1. And we have a random sample of 75 values of a variable X. So as I was mentioning, because we don't know which variable X is it, it can be normal distribution, it can be Poisson distribution. So the problem is, sir, because we don't know which distribution it is, so we are making an unbiased estimate of the population parameter here by applying the formulas given by the mathematicians or statisticians, okay? So we have to find the unbiased estimates for the population mean and variance, students. So it's not a big problem. All the values are given. Again, this is a 3-mark question as well, sir. So small marks are given for these questions. We have been given N is 75. Follow carefully. The sample size is 75. Summation of X is this thing. And we also have summation of X is this thing. And summation of X square is the 340.24. So here we go, sir. It will be simple. You will say that X bar, follow carefully, students. It will be simple, sir. The X bar is equals to X bar. The mu hat will be summation of X divided by the N. So 1 mark will be simple for this thing. 153.2 divided by 75, okay? So summation of X divided by N. So it will be 153.2 divided by 75, okay? Understood, getting it, students? Make sure any questions can be asked in the comment section. So I will give the answer to 3 significant figures. That will be 2.04. I think that is enough. 2.04 will be correct according to marking scheme, and we have got the full 1 mark here for giving the answer as 2.04. When we talk about the unbiased estimate of the population variance, sir, so let's work it out. Unbiased estimates. So these are basically unbiased estimates. This is the heading for concept number 3, students. So now we are working out that, sir, this will be S square, that is the variance. So 1 divided by N minus 1, sample size minus 1, so it will be 75 minus 1, sir. And I'm going to multiply this with summation of X square, that is, sir, basically 340.24 summation of X square minus summation of X whole square. So it will be 153.2 whole square divided by sample size, that is 75. First, you simplify and solve this and get the answer again to 3 significant figures or 2 decimal places. So we got 340.24 in the calculator, bracket 153.2 whole square divided by 75, sir. And whatever the answer is coming, this multiply by 1 over 74. So I'm getting 0.36 something. So it will be round off to three significant three decimal places, 0.369 will be my answer for the sample variance. Okay, so this is how you got the 3 marks by doing ample working, students. Hope everyone gets this. Very simple, very clear. This is basically, sir, concept number 3, unbiased estimates. Just have to do the workings, apply the formula, and get the answer for the unbiased estimates of population, mean, and the variance. Okay, make sure to take a screenshot as well. Let's do another question as well. This is basically a similar variant. Okay, this is basically a similar variant. I'll show it again. This is what we have done. If anyone have any questions, do ask. Okay, when we're talking about this question, it's exactly a similar question, sir. Again, on concept number 3, question number 38, May, June 2019, this is more recent, okay? So this is more recent paper on concept number 3 being tested, sir. Again, this is unbiased estimates of the population. So when we talk about concept number 3, we need to understand that this is a bit different question, but it surrounds around the formulas, okay? The formulas that we have discussed, you have to apply those formulas again. And the length of the worms, so we have the length of the worms is denoted by X centimeter. Again, we don't know whether it's Poisson, normal, abnormal, or binomial. So that is why we are using a population parameter, that is unbiased estimate. So what we have, sir, is basically the length of the random sample of 50 worms were measured, and some of the results were lost, but the following results are available. So some of the results were lost, but some results are available. Random sample of 50 worms, so sample size is 50, summation of x square is given, an unbiased estimate of population variance is given. We have to calculate the mean length of 50 worms, okay, students? So we have to work out the mean length of 50 worms, so very important. So as always, always start with the information that is given, students, okay? So always start with the information. So we have been given the population variance. So it will be 9.62 population variance is equals to summation of x square. Do we have that? So let me write down the formula here. S square is equals to 1 divided by n minus 1 into summation of x square minus summation of x to the whole square divided by n, sir, and this whole in the bracket multiplied, okay? So if you look at it, if you look at it here, students, sorry for this. If you look at it here, we already have 9.62 as the population variance, and we already have the sample size, that is 50 worms. So it will be 50 minus 1, that is 49. And you can multiply this by saying that this is 4361. We don't have just summation of x to the whole square. We don't have this thing, while we have always other information, while we have all the other information available, students, okay? So I'll repeat my point, students. We have the sample variance available, and we can apply just in the formula to get the summation of x square first. So let's try to work it out. So it will be 9.62. Let's do it here. 9.62 is equals to 1 over 49 multiply by 4361 minus this summation of x whole square we don't have divided by 50. And here we go. Let's start working on this. So let's first multiply. I'm going to multiply 9.62 with 49, students. So I'm getting, it was coming 471.38, okay? 471.38 is equals to this thing. What you can do is basically change the positions, okay? So I'll change the positions now. It will be, sir, simple. What we can say here is basically summation of x whole square divided by 50 is equals to 4361 minus 471.38. And now you will get the further answer as well. Hope everyone is getting it. Let's try to finish this up, wind it up. Okay, guys. So it will be, let's say, do it in the calculator. So 4361 minus this value, and we are getting something, and you multiply that by 50. Okay, so make sure students understand. You multiply that answer by 50, sir. So I am getting the whole thing as 194,481, which you can do the square root then next, okay? Put the square root on both sides, students, to get the summation of x value, okay? So hope everyone got this and it's clear. This one and this will cancel out. So here we go. We got this as basically summation of x is basically square root of this, sir. 441 is the summation of x. Make sure, students, this is up till now you have achieved 2 marks only by working it out, which is a lengthy working here. You have only got 2 marks because you have got summation of x as 441. Make sure you have to find the mean length and what is the mean length of the unbiased estimate of population, mean and variance. So let's do it here in this box. Okay, let me make a box. This is the formula that I've put in here, and the rest all are the workings. Okay, students. So here we go. It will be simple, sir, that we have got the answer now. What is the formula? So it will be, sir, x bar is equals to summation of x divided by n. Summation of x is basically, sir, 441 divided by 50. 441 divided by 50 is coming, sir, 8.82, and that is the answer for 3 marks. So they can little bit test you by giving a completely different question as well, but the concept and the formulas remain the same, so you can apply and do a hard question as well. This is the answer, students. Make sure copy this down, take the notes of all the lectures, okay, all the concepts, okay, and practice as many questions as possible. Make sure to share the answers with me. I'll give one more question as well to you as homework, so make sure everyone try this question and take a screenshot of this and tell me in the comments section of how will you solve this unbiased estimates. Just have to use the same formula. It's just a bit different variant that you will have to do all the workings. You will have to get summation of x square by squaring all the numbers and then adding it, just like the representation of data from the statistics chapter. However, hope everyone have got the screenshot for this. This is the formula for the unbiased estimate of population, mean and variance. We'll continue from here.